In this video, we are going to discuss the maximum and minimum values of a function. If we consider a function y is equals to f of x, so as shown, so ito ay y is equals to f of x, whose graph is yun, pinakita na natin. So as indicated, this function is continuous of for all values of x in the interval a is less than x, where x is less than b, and has a continuous derivative except at points P4 or point 4 and point 5. So kasi hindi siya ano no, hindi siya curve diyan no. So hindi siya continuous derivative diyan yung point 4 at saka point 5. But in point 2 and 3, okay siya no. So at point 2, f of x diyan is less than the f of function x sub 2 for all values of x near x sub 2. Then it is called a maximum point. So ito, ito yung tinutukoy ko dito, yan. So and the corresponding ordinate function of x sub 2, so ito no, function of f sub 2 is a maximum value of f of x, wherein the P2 or P sub 2 may not be the highest point of the curve, but it is the highest point within some interval of the curve or within its neighborhood or vicinity. So kaya tinawag natin siyang maximum point because nandun yung maximum value of f of x. Next, consider natin yung point P sub 3 which is lower than any other point. So itong point P sub 3 no, so lower siya. So therefore it is lower than any other point of the curve within its immediate neighborhood or vicinity. Hence P sub 3 is called a minimum point. So, sulat na lang natin. So, this would be a maximum point and this would be our minimum point. At point P4 and point P5, the derivative is said to be the discontinuous. Discontinuous siya. So, ang P sub 4 and P sub 5, discontinuous. Then, at these points, the derivative f prime of x becomes infinite and are neither maximum nor minimum points. So, ulitin natin yun, ha? At points P4 and P5, neither minimum or maximum yung points doon. So, points at which our derivative is zero or has an infinite discontinuity are called the critical points of the function, and corresponding values of the functions at these points are called the critical value. To test for the maximum and minimum values, first we need to find the first derivative of a function. So una, get the f prime na lang, no? F prime x or y prime, no? Yan ay derivative. Of course, dapat simplified, no? Then the second one, equate the first derivative to zero. Dapat yung f prime of x natin, ma-equate natin siya to zero. Or y prime is equals to zero. Then, solve for the real roots. Kailangan natin kunin yung the real roots. Okay. Ngayon, pag nahanap natin yung roots dyan, yun yung magiging critical points. And for number 4, that is the second derivative of the function. Yan. That would be, pwede din siyang y raised to 2. Yan. And then, dito naman, makikita natin yung kung ang function ay in minimum or maximum siya, yung point. No? Kaya, kung after nakuha natin yung second derivative, kukunin natin or titingnan natin yung positive and negative value. Pag negative yung lumabas, that is our maximum point. Okay? Pag positive yung lumabas, that is our minimum point. After natin yan ha, na makuha yung second derivative. Okay? So let's take the first example. Example number 1. Determine the critical points, maximum and minimum points, and points of inflection. So, example 1 natin, y is equals to x cubed minus 9x squared plus 15x minus 3. So sabi natin sa rules natin kanina, get the f prime of x, yung derivative. So kailangan natin kunin yung derivative nito. So y prime or first derivative, that would be 3x squared minus 18x plus 15. Okay? And then we have to simplify. Sabi, isi-simplify natin to. So pwede natin tong gawin. So ilabas natin yung 3 multiplied by x squared minus 6x plus 5. Yan. Para makuha natin, yung goal dito is makuha yung factor natin to and yung real roots niya, no? So x squared minus 6x plus 5. So ito na lang yung kailangan nating i-factor out. Okay? So paano tayo magpa-factor out niyan? So that is just yung x squared minus 6x plus 5, that is equals to a quantity x minus 1 multiplied by x minus 5. Kasi pag nag-foil tayo dyan, no, lalabas yan, that is x squared tapos negative 1x, negative 5x, then negative 1x plus negative 5x, that is negative 6x. Okay? Kaya, ito yan. So, x squared, negative 1x, negative 5x, and then, the last one is positive 5. Kasi negative 1 times negative 5 is positive 5. Okay, so ito, kailangan natin itong i-simplify. X squared, negative 6x plus 5. Therefore, yung factor nito ay quantity x minus 1 and quantity x minus 5. Lagay natin ito dito, y prime is equals to 3 multiplied by quantity x minus 1 multiplied by quantity x minus 5. Ngayon, para makuha natin yung roots o real roots nito, kailangan natin siyang i-equate natin to into 0. So that would be x minus 1 is equals to 0. Therefore, transpose natin, x is equals to 1. For the next roots naman, x minus 5 is equals to 0. Therefore, that is x is equals to 5. Meron na tayong nakuha na value of x. Ngayon, kukunin natin yung y. Paano natin kukunin yung y? Kasi meron na tayong x, ano? Lagay ko dito yung x. Yung first x natin, that is, lagay ko na lang x sub 1. 1. So, kailangan natin kunin yung y sub 1. Yung x sub 2 natin ay 5. Kailangan natin kunin yung y sub 2. So, paano natin makukuha? We need to substitute this x value dun sa original equation natin. Dito na lang sa baba. Yung original equation natin is y is equals to x cube minus 9x squared plus 15x minus 3. Substitute mo yung 1. Ito, oh. Kailangan mo yung i-substitute dyan. So, that would be y is equals to 1 cube minus 9 times 1 squared plus 15 times 1 minus 3. Okay? And that would be 1. Ito ay negative 9. 1 squared is 1 multiplied by 9 is negative 9. 15 times 1 is 15 plus 15 minus 3. And that would become, lan to, 1 minus 9 is 8 plus 15. So that would be 7 minus 3 is, that is 4. So there were y is equals to 4. Yun yung ilalagay natin dito. When x is 1, therefore y is 4. Now let us have this value naman. Y is equals to 5 cubed minus 9 times 5 squared plus 15 times 5 minus 3. So this would be 125 minus 5 squared is 25 times 9, that is 225 plus 15 times 5 is 75 minus 3. Then you will get negative 28. So therefore, our y sub 2 here is negative 28. So meron na tayong points, ano? Meron tayong points dito na dalawa, no? Ito yung point 1 at saka ito yung point 2. Lagay ko na lang dito, point 1, point 2. Pero di natin alam kung alin dyan yung maximum at saka minimum, diba? Di pa natin sure kung alin dyan yung maximum at saka minimum point. Ngayon, pero ito na yung hinahanap natin na critical points, ha? This value now here is our critical points. Yan. So, meron na tayong nahanap. Yan, critical points. Check. The second na hahanapin natin is the maximum and minimum points. So, according dito sa ating steps, kailangan nating, nakuha na natin to, no? Nakuha na natin yung critical value. So, get the second derivative to, in order for us to know the maximum and minimum point. So, y prime natin, ano yung y prime? So, y prime is 3x squared minus 18x plus 15. Sabi natin, kunin natin yung second derivative. So, that would be 6x minus 18. Then, simplified natin to. Second derivative would be 6 multiplied by x minus 3. Kasi pagka nag-distributive tayo dyan, lalabas din, that is 6x minus 18 yan. Now, let us replace yung x sub 1 and x sub 2. So, meron tayo dyan na 1 and then 5. Get natin muna yan. So, y double prime, when x is, sulat natin, when x sub 1 is equals to 1, y double prime or y second derivative natin ng function is 6 multiplied by yung x na 1 minus 3. And y double prime natin dito, that is equals to, lang to, 1 minus 3 is negative 2 times 6, that is negative 12. Okay? So, ilalagay natin to dito, y to the second power. Kasi second derivative siya eh. So, ilagay ko na lang yan dyan na negative 12. Yan. And then, pag 5 naman, y 6 times 5 minus 3, that would be 5 minus 3 is 2 times 6, that is 12 din. Pero positive siya. Ayan, positive 12. So, therefore, meron tayong nahanap na negative and positive. Ngayon, balikan natin yung rules kanina. Sabi doon, maximum siya kung negative. So, therefore, ang maximum value pala natin is itong 1. Ito pala yung maximum. No? Kasi dito natin nakuha yung negative. Meron kasi itong negative. Okay? And then, minimum naman itong positive. Ayan, minimum to. Kasi positive siya eh. So, therefore, yung x sub 2 natin na 5, ito yung mean. Lagyan ko ng ibang kulay. Ito yung mean. Ito yung max. Okay? So, meron na tayong minimum at maximum point. Okay na to. Okay? Now, for the point of inflection, kailangan nating kunin naman from this second derivative. Di ba meron na tayong ito? Yan. Solving for the point of inflection. From the second derivative, we have here 6 multiplied by x minus 3. Kunin natin yung roots. Ano ba yung roots natin dito? Yung x minus 3, no? So, x minus 3 is equals to 0. That would be x is equals to 3. Okay? So, if yung x natin ay 3, yun yung isa-substitute natin sa original equation. So, that would be y is equals to 3 cubed minus 9 times 3 squared plus 15 times 3 minus 3. And then, this would become, ilan to? 9, 20, 3 times 3 times 3, that would 27, 3 times 2, 9 times 9, yan, plus 15 times 3 minus 3. And that would be negative 12. Therefore, our point of inflection here is equals to 3 and negative 12. Okay? Kung igagrap natin yan, grap tayo. We have here the x and y value. Okay? Yung first natin na points is 1 and 4. So, get natin, no? 1, kunyari na lang, no? Kasi unlucky pala. So, dito ko na lang ilalagay yung sa, tapos nandito sa baba yung pangalawa. Kunyari lang to. Kasi ito yung point natin na isa. So, that would be point 1. That is 1 and 4. And yung point 2 natin ay 5 and negative 28. Ayan. Then, i-connect natin yan. Siyempre, yung ating curve ng equation na ito ay ganyan. Ayan. So, passing at the zero. Then, pag ganyan yan, siyempre, tatamaan niya yung lower. Ayan. Then, ganyan. Okay? Bala na kayo mag-interpret dyan. Ngayon, ito yung first point natin. Ito yung second point natin. Sabi natin yun yung maximum. Yung x dito, yun yung maximum. Therefore, nandito yung max. Nandito yung mean. And then, yung point of inflection natin na nahanap ay 3 and negative 12. So, somewhere here. Diba? So, dito yan. So, 3 and negative 12. Ito yung ating point of inflection. Okay? By summarizing, nahanap kaagad natin using this test steps, no, for maximum and minimum values. Ang dami nating nahanap, yung critical points, yung maximum and minimum point, and then of course the point of inflection using the steps na binigay ni Matias. Okay? So, kung gagamitin niyo yung first derivative test, same lang din naman yung mga makukuha nyo dito na value. Okay? Yan. So, I hope malinaw yan. But let us come to the next example. Example number 2, if we have y is equals to x cubed minus 3x squared minus 9x, syempre kunin natin yung derivative niya, y prime is equals to 3x squared minus 6x minus 9. Okay? Now, from here, we need to simplify this. So, ito ay magiging 3 multiplied by x squared minus 2x minus 3. Yan. And then, factor natin ito. So, that would be 3 times x plus 1 quantity x minus 3. No? Gawin nyo na lang to. Verify natin yan mamaya. Gawin nyo yan in your own way kung paano natin to na factor out. Okay, so by this, get the roots. So, x plus 1 is equals to 0. Therefore, x is equals to negative 1. Then, if x is negative 3, equate natin sa 0. So, x is equals to positive 3. So, we have here negative 1 and negative 3. So, P1, point 1 is x sub 1 natin ay negative 1. Then, yung x sub 2 natin sa point 2, that would be 3. Okay? Now, kunin natin yung y. So, paano natin makukuha yung y? Substitute natin siya sa dito, sa original equation. So substituting this to the equation, the original equation, y is equals to 5. So, if x is negative 1, y is equals to 5. If x is, for the next point, y is equals to 3 cubed minus 3 times 3 squared minus 9 times 3, and we will get y is equals to negative 27. So, y is equals to negative 27 here. Ito na yung ating critical point. Now, let us get the second derivative para makuha natin yung maximum and minimum, no? So, from y prime is equals to 3x squared minus 6x minus 9. Kunin natin yung second derivative niyan. So, that would be 6x minus 6. Okay? Or, that is 6 times the quantity x minus 1. Then, we substitute the value of x sub 1 and x sub 2 here. Dalawa, no? Ayan. So, x sub 1 and x sub 2. So, if f sub 1, that would be 6 times na yung x sub 1 natin, negative 1 minus 1. So, negative 1 times negative 1 times, negative 1 minus negative 1 times 6, that is equals to, yung y natin dito is equals to negative 12. Ginagawa ko lang siyang mayroong ditong 2, no? Kasi galing siya dito sa second derivative kasi. Pero huwag kayong malito, no? Kahit tanggalin nyo yan, basta nakuha nyo na yung y value natin. For x sub 2 naman, 6 times 3 minus 1. So, that would be y is equals to 12. So again, using our steps, kapag negative siya, this would be our maximum, and positive, this would be our minimum. Now, getting for the, ilagay muna natin dito, yung point, no? So that would be x sub 1 is equals to negative 1, y is equals to negative 12, x sub 2 is 3, y is equals to positive 12. Using second derivative na to, no? Second derivative. Ito yung ating max, ito yung ating min, point. Okay? Now, getting the point of inflection. So, from here, kunin natin yung point of inflection. Y is equals to 6, quantity x minus 1. So, x minus 1 is equals to 0. X is equals to 1. And then, we need to substitute that to the equation. So, 1 cubed minus 3 times 1 squared minus 9 times 1. And yung y natin dito ay negative 11. Therefore, our point of inflection is x is equals to 1 and y is equals to negative 11. Okay? So, I hope you learned something in this tutorial video entitled Maximum and Minimum Values of a Function. Thank you.